It's a drug you can buy in cities across the U.S., and it's increasingly making headlines. Dangerous chemical combinations, often referred to as bath salts, are being blamed for dozens of episodes of bizarre, violent behavior. A New York mother suspected of being high on the chemicals was photographed running around naked before police reportedly used a stun gun to subdue her. She eventually died. She allegedly beat her three-year-old son, and witnesses described her as being out of control.
And she got a hold of one of her dogs, and she was rolling around on the ground, her arms wrapped around it, her legs wrapped around it, and she was strangling the dog.
It comes weeks after the gruesome murder in Miami where a man ate the face of his victim. Authorities say bath salts may have been involved. Bath salts is a catch-all nickname being given to a group of synthetic stimulants meant to mimic the effects of illegal drugs like meth, cocaine, and LSD. They're sold at convenience stores like this one in New Hampshire, where a recent raid seized $100,000 worth. An undercover detective who wanted his identity protected on CNN's Aaron Burnett out front described a user he encountered.
She was actually picking apart her skin, saying that she felt when she was on it that she had bugs in her skin. She was severe hallucinogenics. She stated feeling an out-of-body experience, and extreme paranoia was one of the indicators that she said that she often feels when she was on eight balls or bath salts.
And earlier this week in Indiana, police raided six gas stations which were selling them. Poison centers around the country have seen a rise in calls linked to bath salts. More than 40 states have banned bath salts and other chemicals that can be used to get high legally. But Special Agent Jeffrey Scott with the Drug Enforcement Administration says it's not that simple. He says the DEA last year banned three of the most commonly used chemicals found in these drugs.
Even as I'm speaking now, you know, the formulations are changing, the chemicals themselves are changing, and we've seen it as something of a game of whack-a-mole. You ban or regulate, schedule three chemicals, and then three more appear, and then five more. So that represents a challenge.